Hey, Mayor, it's Mike. Look, I gotta head downtown for a few days, maybe longer. If Reno calls, tell him to meet me down there. We got something to discuss, apparently. I'll be at Milton's place in the Skyline Lofts 2A. Sorry, baby. I'll explain everything later. Thank you.
need a date?
Hello, L.A. You're up way past your bedtime, aren't you? Hope you've slipped into something comfortable. I know I have. If you're new to town or just new to this whole radio thing, you're listening to The Devil Man, the only girl who will spend the night with you and leave first thing in the morning, guaranteed. Well, looks like the boards are lighting up. Aren't I the popular one? Let's see. Hello, L.A. You're up way past your bedtime, aren't you? Hope you've slipped into something comfortable. I know.
Hey there, hot stuff.
If you're new to town or just new to this whole radio thing, you're listening to...
So what'd you find out about money? All right, then. I'll have to call in some bounty hunters to help me find Muddy and a couple of other jumpers. Thanks for all your help. Oh, right. Sorry about that. Here you are.
Rico. So.
See you around then. Rico, if you ever find yourself or a loved one locked up, please call.
Yacht Club?
How many boats do you own, Rico?
Two. Actually, three. One is.
What'll it be, honey? Is that a trick question? Pale girls. Oh, like the Fitzsimmons albino. Yeah, she hasn't been in here in ages. Let me think. Oh yeah, about 4 dozen a week. Thin blood. Sounds familiar. Is that one of those tropical diseases? I know I've heard that before. Oh, that girl. Nice girl. First decent human being I've seen in here for years. Not like all the junkies and crazies I normally see. Yeah, I remember her. Yeah, weird. She left a tip, but she didn't order a thing. Yeah, she looked so hungry, too. Just sat there all night with a full glass of water in front of her, talking about this and that. She seemed lonely, a little scared, so I let her stay in the booth until we closed. She left some stuff here. You seem to know her. Why don't you give it back to her if you run into her?
Not today.
Evening.
Evening.
Just back off.
Hey there. Need a date?
To scorn the Lord's love, the damned laugh loudest before they lose their heads.
Hello, LA. You're up way past your bedtime, aren't you? But we've slipped into something comfortable. If you're new to town or just new to this whole radio thing, you're listening to the. Hello, LA.
Hey there! Need something specific, like, or just here to Yeah? What do you want to know? Sure, honey, what is it?
Caller, you've got the first shot at Deb tonight. So, who do I have the pleasure of speaking to?
Hi, Deb.
These streets, walk, lead to the spinal columns of the great beast's hall. All you walk willingly to the eternal feast!
Something I can help you with. Goodbye, then.
Hey, sorry. Not today.
Really?
Need some company?
Being. No, no, you are going to China. Why is he smiling? The father. Is it the father behind him? You chased it for the one at the top of the city. On the sea. Oh, on the ground. You found it in the crypt. It's open. Oh, it's open. Oh, God. Oh, God. Run. I'm sorry. Sometimes I see nothing. Disregard what I say. I don't know what I'm saying. Forget what I say. Fortune is not your destiny. All of us are unfortunate. Every time I sleep, the future plays out before me. I know the end of it. It will end over and over until I cease to dream. I know your questions. For $100, I'll tell you what you don't want to hear. I need money to leave this place. Then ask again. The Crimson Sheep. He's not who he says she is, and is going to burn. Dinosaurs. He's furious. The man with the crest. The voice in the darkness. Boss. Chinese brothers. Follow the lights to the end of the tunnel. Where do you want to go? The man on the couch. The lone wolf. All others, tread carefully. Those with a lot to say usually have something on their mind. There are many unique individuals around the city. It's almost as if they're waiting for you to ask the right thing. E, for example. Many, everywhere. Some with swords, some with smiles. But I pity them. You are a remarkable foe. I see the future, not the past. Don't open it. Whether or not you win the game matters not. It's if you bought it.
Evening. It's nothing. No, I have a speech problem. Sorry.
Shh, mayhem, bro.
Do you know who the head vampire is? If the head vampire dies, we all become human again, right? Oh. But, how about blood transfusions? If I get a full blood transfusion, I can become human again, right? What? Oh, no. There's nothing I can do?
Look at the ocean. I used to love swimming out into her at the crack of dawn. Be my guest. Seems no one will talk about it. This all started that night.
You're gonna have to move along now.
Lovely evening. It's a nice night out, huh?
I'm busy.
Good evening to you.
Please, wait your turn and you'll be seen. All right, go on back.
Thank you.
Nurse.
I'm sorry, miss, but you're going to have to wait outside like everyone else. No exceptions. Oh, what time is it?
You next up for the needle? Hmm? Your donation could save a life, you know. Oh, but isn't it a little late for altruism? I don't think you're here to give blood at all. I don't buy it, Jack. I bet you're here to take blood. Am I right? They all come in here with that same nonchalant look. With that, who, me, stare? As if they were so clever. Do you think you're the first vampire to try and come in here to buy blood? Honestly. If you have to ask. No. Queen Bitch would say no to that. Now serving number 26. Number 26. 26.
No.
There. I'm afraid you are committing a 351. That's trespassing on private property. I'm gonna have to ask that you vacate the premises immediately, or I'm afraid I'll be forced to radio this in. Well, Missy, that's just a natural response that people have to someone in my kind of position. Huh? The risk, the prestige, the authority. It's a tough job, but somebody's got to do it. Yeah, you know, you'd be surprised how often I hear that in this line of work. It's the uniform, you know. Women just can't get over the uniform. Well, unfortunately, if I continue to engage you in conversation, it's a violation of Code 613.
Where is that what damn is that tow truck?
My loafer. I'm going to need a shower.
What were you thinking? How could you give her that item from the hotel? Do you know what she did with it? She threw it into the Pacific. Do you know what this means? It means that I can't get rid of the spirit now, which means that that property is useless to me. And to make matters worse, someone's just gone and ruined my event at the gallery. Shut up! I thought I could control my sister as long as Tongue was out of the picture, but nothing's changed. Because of them, I'm in a worse position than I was before. The Ocean House is worthless! So our business is forfeit. The feud is on! We had an agreement. You blew that agreement. Even if my sister was at fault, you played into her hands. And I've all but had her destroyed for her actions against me. In fact, I may have been too severe with her. Don't you think I'm aware of that? This is my city. I know everything that goes on, from borders to beach. But listen to me, fledgling. If you want to please your prince, you'll do what I ask. I'll make it easy this time. I made some threats against my sister. Idle threats, involving fire and her impious satin sheets. She took them quite seriously, and is avoiding me. I want to meet with her, and explain that they were said in the heat of the moment. I asked her to meet me at the Surfside Diner, to reconcile. But I'm busy with the club and my other endeavors. I'd like you to go to the diner and promise her that I don't plan to take any action against her. Wait for her in the back booth, near the phones. I want to see my sister. Yes, I'll call it off once I've spoken with her myself. Just do what I ask.
Yeah.